Good evening, families and friends. My name is Isabella Castro.
And I'm Alexandra Ruiz.
And we are proud to serve as the presidents of the Academy of Business and Finance and to be your masters of ceremonies for today's event.
We would like to thank you all for joining us here today to celebrate the graduation of the Class of 2020 Academy of Business and Finance. Before we begin, we would like to welcome some special guests who will be joining us this evening. Mr. Juan Carlos Gonzalez from the South Florida Educational Federal Credit Union, Ms. Karina Alonso, and Ms. Antoinette Lodge-Johnson.
We ask you to please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now, the singing of the National Anthem by Isabella Myers.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the
created by Chloe Barrowett and Anna Marquez for memories of the graduates' time here.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. When the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Suffer, but take the pain. where I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up.
Congratulations, Corey, class of 2020. I'm so proud of you guys, and a special shout out to my sixth period. You guys know who you are. Good times. You know, I just want to wish all of you the best, and please do your best to make this world a better place for all of us. Best wishes, and stay safe.
Congratulations, class of 2020. This is Miss Mercurius. I'm very glad to have been your teacher for the last school year. I am hoping all of your dreams come true and you're very successful in whatever career path that you choose. All the best. See you guys around.
Dear class of 2020, Mrs. Bolt apologizes she couldn't be here, but she sent her British alter ego. She shared that she's had wonderful memories with you and she'll always treasure that time. She's also asked me to let you know that if you always reach for the moon and you miss, you'll land among the stars. If opportunity doesn't knock, you should build a door and remember to be above reproach at all times. Congratulations, NAF graduates, class of 2020.
Hi, class of 2020. I miss you guys. Hope all is well. You know, you had to overcome and endure a situation that no other senior class ever experienced. I'm confident that you're stronger now, and I have no doubts that you're equipped and prepared to conquer any obstacles that you will face in the future. Yes, I will miss seeing you at graduation, watching you enjoy your special moment. Remember, 4 years ago, we discussed the foundation of building your high school success. And when the foundation was placed, we needed stability in year two. Then as juniors, the order was set and the theme was justification to get everything in place for submission during your senior year. Wow, class of 2020, congratulations. You made it to the top of the cake. Enjoy, much love to all of you and all the best. God bless.
Hi, seniors. Ms. Lodge Johnson here. What more fitting than making this recording in the middle of Staples. I had to feel like I was in the classroom speaking with my students. Unfortunately, I'm getting eyes from everywhere, but they'll be okay. Let me take this time to say that I am so proud of each and every one of you. I love you. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to finish this ride that we started 4 years ago, but please know that there hasn't been a passing moment that I haven't thought about each and every one of you, our projects, Mad City Money, all of those fantastic things that we did in class, our projects. I do want to say that this is your next chapter. This is your important chapter. The ball is now in your court. As I said so many times before, whether you play to lose, you play to remain average, or you play to win, these are your choices now. I'm hoping that each and every one of you take what was taught to you in stride and move forward. Let me tell you, move forward with the desire to want to become something great in life. The sky is the limit, and you are prepared to take on the challenges. Remember, I don't like losing. I don't want to get those reports that any of my kids. And remember, you are my kids. You were with me more than you were with your parents. I love each and every one of you. You take care. You be blessed. And remember, we're always here for you. Unfortunately, we're living in a time now where it's out of our control. But this too shall pass. And watch the blessings flow. Watch the benefits of your hard work. I love each and every one of you. Take care. And congratulations again.
We will now be recognizing students for their hard work and dedication to completing the NAF program. Ms. Anna Mirabal, Academy of Finance Lead Teacher, will now be announcing the 2020 National Business Honor Society NAFTRAC Certified Graduates.
The National Business Honor Society, or NBHS, is an organization that honors and nationally recognizes outstanding students in our business academy. NAFTRAC certification is achieved through an online system created by education and business professionals to assess college and career readiness. These students have completed the program requirements of Coral Reef High School's Business Academy. They've passed all of their NAF courses, all of their end of course exams, completed their culminating projects, industry certifications, and participated in a paid internship. These students are Ashley Alfaro, Kevin Alfonso, Alberto Ambard, Alex Aronson, Lauren Kaye, Sydney Kaye, Audrey Castagnon, Brylan Christopher, Jack Cohen, Diego Concha Fernandez, Genesis de Rosario, Haley Diaz, Jenny Elias, Stephen Eustace, Caitlin Fundora, Mariam German, Maria Giambarba, Laura Guillen Avila, Carmen Lee, Adam Linares, John Lux, Natalia Madruga, Anna Marquez, Nicole Marquez, Anthony Masso, Zachary Miller, Andrea Mullen, Michelle Nugent, Stephanie Ortega, Sean Perez, Ashawn Pericles, Maura Pinder, Leslie Potente, Anjali Pro, Alyssa Reyes, Carolina Rodriguez, Patrick Roth, Yvette Salto, Johnny Santana, Andy Santana Rodriguez, Matthew Scholl, Gabriela Sumbu, Nabil Torres, Vanessa Torres, Jordan Utrera, Evelyn Valdez, Christina Valori, Christopher Varela, Zachary Wiener, Imani White, and Aaron Yaroshuk. And now I'll be announcing the 2020 NAF Track Certified graduates. Ashley Artiles, Donovan Benavides, Callie Brown, Shania Bryant, Tyler Buckner, Genesis Caceres, Adriana Castellanos, Ryan Chisholm, Nicholas Espinal, Morella Espinosa, Skylar Estavillo, Joseph Figueroa, Amanda Garcia Paravicini, Raymond Gonzalez, Julian Gutierrez, Ray Harrington, Yoselin Hernandez, Armando Herrera, Darian Hunt, Kathy Iglesias, Sebastian Jimenez Infante, Gustavo Knapp, Safran Koppelman, Andrew Lee, Ian Lee, Suyed Losa, Yoemi Martin, Albert Martinez, Lauren McEwen, Carla Moyenedo, Vincent Montano, Alexander Morales, Danny Moreno, Alex Morgan, Norman Morse, Austin Nolasco, Austin Nutter, Damian Padron, Justin Palma, Daniel Patel, Anthony Perez, Thomas Reardon, William Riggenbach, Alexander Rodriguez, Alejandro Salazar, James Seymour Newton, Zavin Thomas, Guillermo Torres, Jordan Vergel, Alexa Vigueras, and Sofia Yevesheva. And now, the Academy of Finance program completers. These students have completed the Coral Reef High School Business Academy program, but did not reach the NAF Track certification. Marlon Alvarez, Zachary Arana, Daniel Arango, Emilio Arguello, Alexander Bovard, Christopher Chavez, Ashley Cordova, Esteban Cruz, Dorian Daniels, Juan Duran, Heather Fritz, Alexander Garcia, Yuswan Garcia, Jada Harris, Michael Licona, Jose Lopez, Felix Martinez, Kalia McNeil, Sydney Moore, Cindy Narder, Nicholas Orozco, Jordan Pineda, George Salmeron, and Ashley Siegler.
Thank you, Ms. Mirabal.
Catherine Rogers, upcoming co-president of FBLA from the class of 2021, will now be presenting board members with their Lead to Feed cords.
Lead to Feed is a leadership program that nurtures a new generation of leaders. This year, our chapter held a drive to help the victims of Hurricane Dorian. We are proud to announce that Coral Reef FBLA placed fourth in Lead to Feed, receiving $2,700 for the chapter. The following students played a major role in this accomplishment: Haley Diaz, Miriam German, Gustavo Knapp, Adam Linares, Anna Marquez, Nicole Marquez, Michelle Wynn, Mara Pinder, Leslie Potente, Anyeli Pro, Catalina Rodriguez, Christopher Varela, and Zachary Wiener.
And now, Mr. Juan Carlos Gonzalez, who will be presenting the South Florida Educational Federal Credit Union Intern Awards.
Hello, my name is Juan Carlos Gonzalez from the South Florida Educational Federal Credit Union. On behalf of the credit union, I would like to acknowledge and recognize those graduating seniors from Coral Reef Senior High School who have participated in either our school branch program or our summer youth internship program. Every year, the credit union has the opportunity to handpick a select number of students to participate in the school branch program at Coral Reef Senior High, affectionately known as CUDA Credit Union. Those students receive hands-on experience working in a financial setting where they have the opportunity to understand how to market the credit union to the remainder of the student body and faculty. Within the summer youth internship program, those summer interns have a unique opportunity to work with a variety of departments, including our marketing, legal, accounting departments, assisting in projects that require a unique perspective, more of a student's perspective over those summer months. So again, we greatly appreciate all of the help and assistance that these students have provided in those two different programs. So we'd like to go ahead and acknowledge those students at this time. The students are Michelle Nguyen, Miriam Herman, Nicole Marquez, Anna Marquez, Zachary Wiener, Gustavo Knapp, Maura Pinder, Adam Linares, Darian Hunt, and Norman Morse. We thank you again so much for everything, and we truly believe that only the best is ahead for each and every one of you. Thank you.
Ms. Anna Mirabal will now be extending a special recognition to some of the hardest working and most dedicated students of the Academy of Finance.
The following students have contributed vast amounts of time and effort into improving our academy and making it into what it is today. These students have served as role models, leaders, and innovators throughout their time in the Business Academy. Their dedication will not go unnoticed, so please join me in thanking Haley Diaz, Mariam German, Maria Giambarba, Gustavo Knapp, Adam Linares, Anna Marquez, Nicole Marquez, Gianna Martinez, Michelle Nguyen, Maura Pinder, Leslie Potente, Anyeli Pro, Carolina Rodriguez, Christopher Varela, and Zachary Wiener. We wouldn't be able to accomplish a huge part of what we do for our students if it wasn't for the amazing contribution of our parents. Every year, our booster parents and our booster board work so hard to provide activities and fundraising and just total support for our students in the Business Academy. And every year, I sadly have to bid farewell to to parents that have been working with us since their child first entered through those doors 4 years ago. So please join me in thanking and have our undying gratitude to the following parents: Ana Laura Morales, Katie Loughran, Lynn Wiener, Andrew Giambarba, Sandra and Dan Linares, Evelyn Roth, and Kaylee Baptista. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you so much.
First things first, we would like to begin with a warm and heartfelt thank you to every single teacher, mentor, and administrator who's helped us get to this point.
This graduation is the product of the combined cooperation of so many wonderful people, and we're thankful for each and every one of them.
Although they are not currently teachers at the Reef, every NAF teacher has made an indelible mark on us, including Ms. Johnson and Ms. Alonzo, the first two NAF teachers we had at the Reef.
Thank you to Ms. Johnson for laying the foundation for what we could expect for teachers from the Reef, from the pizza party that never was, to the countless stories about family, friends, lawsuits, and everything in between. We learned that business classes at the Reef would be the classes that we looked forward to.
For Ms. Alonzo, who left the classroom in service of our country, we cannot thank you enough. Though playing Monopoly for a year was a bit less fun in practice than it sounded in the syllabus, sophomore year, so many of us found some of our best friends in your classroom, and we all enjoyed getting to know you. Your anecdotes made us come to love a class that was a bit intimidating to us all at the beginning of the year. You are a great teacher to have, and we appreciate all of your work in service of your country and in service of your students.
As for Ms. Bolt, our love for your class is as strong as your British accent. Every morning when we heard John Mayer on the class speakers, we knew we had a good day in front of us. When there was no music, we had three quizzes and presentations to do. We will miss all those team building exercises that we took so seriously, and the methods to your madness.
Ms. Mercurius, thank you for making your classroom the tropical paradise in the frozen business wing. We appreciate your relentless honesty and willingness to engage with students on a personal level. We appreciate your constant pushing students to certify to put themselves at an advantage.
Ms. Kern-Smith, we cannot thank you enough for your kindness and dedication to our academy. Though the 2 years us seniors spent with you felt all too short, you made sure that each day was meaningful and educational. I think I speak for us all when I say that you showed us kindness without expectation. We all learned the importance of helping out those around you in order to maintain morale. Thank you above all for being someone that we could trust and go to with any problems that we had. We are eternally appreciative of all that you do for our academy.
Thank you to Mr. Hyatt. Your dedication to us, the students, set in place a great foundation of the expectations for the staff of the Business Academy. You were an anchor of stability throughout the rocky college application process and always supported us throughout our 4 years. If we needed to drop by your office, you never asked for any justification and always helped us with any submissions we needed. Thank you for all you've done. Your lectures about the cake have been seared into our minds.
Last, but certainly not least, I would like to give special recognition to our mentor, lead teacher, and academy head, Ms. Mirabal. Thank you for always taking us out of class. That's it. Just kidding. You have been our biggest supporter, our most energetic advocate, and the greatest lead teacher anyone could ever ask for.
From inside the classroom to countless hours spent on FBLA and AOF projects, your dedication to your students is second to none, and our high school experience has been immeasurably enriched because of it.
You never hesitated to reach out to students if they needed a guiding hand, and consistently went above and beyond to ensure that each and every one of us had a learning environment that we genuinely enjoyed. There aren't enough Coke Zeros in the world to show how much we appreciate you.
Although our senior year is not ending as we expected it to, we are still immensely proud to be graduating from such a prestigious academy. The business wing has become a second home for many of us, and we wouldn't have wanted to go through high school any other way.
Though we are all moving on to the next stages of our life now, all of our successes are a result of the amazing educators that we had.
Our 4 years together may be over, but expect many calls, emails, and visits in the years to come.
We will now like to welcome Anieli Pro and Leslie Pontente, who will be summing it up.
Hello to the 2020 graduates of the Academy of Business and Finance. First of all, I want to congratulate each one of you. We made it. We are into the next phase of our life, college. And although this might not be the ideal way to spend the last few months together, we can still reflect on the good. Being your FBLA co-president this past year has taught me to always be prepared for every situation, and that if things don't turn out the way you expect them to turn out, find a way to fix the problem. There are people in this world who find a solution to every problem. And then there are people who find a problem to every solution. Always be the first type. I would like to thank our advisor, Ms. Mirabel, and every single academy teacher that we had over the past 4 years. From the stars of Ms. Johnson to the accounting circle of Ms. Mirabel, to the playlist vibes of Ms. Boltroom and the Microsoft certificates from Ms. Mercurius, I can't express my gratitude enough for every single thing that you've done for me and every single one of us. I would also like to give a huge shout out to the Business and Finance Booster Club and its president, Mrs. Smith. Thank you for the charisma and passion you put in the academy along with the other parents. This is it, Academy of Business students. We are ready to take on the world, but don't ever forget your second home. See you all around the reef and around the world.
Hi guys, I hope everybody is doing well with this whole pandemic thing going on, but I just want to say congratulations to all of us because we finally made it, we finally graduated, even though we didn't actually get a graduation, but I know we're all trying very hard to do the best that we can, especially the business kids. They have been trying very hard. The Academy of Finance Board has been trying very hard to make this easy for us. But I'm just here to say congratulations to all of us because I know some of us didn't think that we were gonna make it, but we did. The Academy of Finance has taught me the person that I am today. It opened me to a whole new world of possibilities. And even though I'm not going down the business route, it has shown me that everything happens for a reason. And I got introduced to be AOF president last year, and I cannot have been more grateful, especially to Ms. Mirabel, which I thank her for, because she opened my eyes and she made me become the person that I didn't know that I was. And I thank her and Ms. Smith so much for welcoming me with open arms and for helping me, and I cannot be more grateful to them. I hope that all of us, all of you, take something along with you and your future from the Academy of Finance. I hope that it opened your eyes to what your career was going to be, or that it showed you some good friends. I really hope that you guys appreciate the 4 years that the Academy has offered you guys. I want to say thank you to all of the teachers, Ms. Johnson, Ms. Bowl, Ms. Mirabel. You guys are truly the best, and even though I know we can be annoying and our senior class is not as productive, I know that you guys have tried with us, and I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. You guys have truly inspired us to be such a great adults with the responsibilities and everything that you guys have offered us. And I just want to say thank you and congratulations, seniors, because we finally made it. We graduated, and it's incredible, but we did it. And here it is to the next 4 years of our life to see what it's going to bring us. And I really hope that we do take advantage of it, because we didn't get to do the high school senior thing, right? I hope that we can do the college thing, right? Thank you, guys. Congratulations once again.
Thank you, Amelia and Leslie. And now we would like to welcome Zachary Wiener, who will be giving a special thanks to the Academy.
Hello, NAF graduates. Congratulations. We made it. As we take the time to look back on our schooling, on how we got to where we are today and where we are going, I would like to ask you all one question. What is the number one thing we have learned in school these past 12 years? No, really, hands down, what is the number one thing that we have incorporated into our lives with such vague yet strong meanings? Think about it. It's growth. We spend years of our life learning about growth. Exponential growth, the growth and decay of substances, the growth of characters in a novel, the growth of empires, even the growth of stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and finances. And it has even become apparent on the news, tragically. Yet, like it too, we have grown. We have become resilient. I speak to you today from my living room in a situation I have never thought possible. Graduation. I am here not because of luck, but in fact, by sheer resilience and determination. We have grown from the situation we are in. We have grown from high school, and most importantly, we have grown from each other. Never will I ever meet a stronger senior class than the one that I am a part of. We posted our decisions online, held Zoom classes, had spirit weeks, learned to cook, clean, and take care of our loved ones, thrived in a situation as terrible as this. We are strong, almighty, resilient teenagers. And I know each and every one of you will carry the same drive on to whatever you do for the rest of your life. Class of 2020, we have gone through more than any teenager dares to go through these past 4 years. And I am grateful to have been a part of it all. I am grateful to have been such a part of an amazing academy with such loving teachers. I have been missing the FBLA events that we've had in the courtyard, getting pies thrown at me, going to the credit union cash machine and grabbing as much cash as I can get my hands on, walking through the business hallway, just knowing how loving and caring every single person in the business academy has been to me and has been to each other these past 4 years. I think we can all say we miss the faces of our friends and miss the faces of the teachers who we love so dear during this time. We all miss Miss Mercurius and her stern yet loving nature, Miss Bolt, and her loud, funny, real-world driven teaching style, and especially Miss Mirabal, who has been like a mom to all 200 plus of us Academy students, wearing her heart on her sleeve every single day, giving us advice on how to be the best person we can be, on how each of us can grow into the person we have wanted to be. NAF, the Academy of Finance, FBLA, and all of our teachers and peers have given us each our own special way of growing these past 4 years. We have grown in spite of adversity, soared to new heights, even leveled up at our state conventions. If there is one thing that I hope you all will take away from me, is this. We have been spending the past 4 years learning about growth. Now is your time too. I challenge you to continue to grow for the rest of your life. To not only grow your character, but to grow your communities, your country, and your world. We are the next generation, and we have fought hard for what we believe in and have persevered so much. I challenge you to keep fighting your battles until you have won. Thank you so much for letting me speak at this NAF graduation, and congratulations again, class of 2020. We deserve it. Go Cudas!
And finally, the Academy of Finance lead teacher, Miss Anna Mirabal, with closing remarks.
Greetings, Academy of Business and Finance graduating class of 2020. While this is not the NAF grad ceremony that any of us envisioned, we are virtually gathered today to celebrate you, our shining stars, to celebrate your accomplishments, to look back on lessons learned, adventures shared, friendships made. But it's also a time to look forward, a time to set new goals, to dream new dreams, to try your wings and see what lies beyond. You are our shining stars. You see, stars capture our imagination. They fuel our dreams and carry out our wishes. On a day like today, there is no better symbol. Each of you is a bright, shining star, just waiting for your turn to soar. You have excelled in every arena. You have proven over and over that nothing is beyond your reach. Your academic excellence, award-winning achievements in FBLA, NBHS, all the extracurricular activities, oh, and we cannot forget, athletic success demonstrate that by all tangible measures, you are the best and the brightest. But you are stars in other more important ways. Truly grateful for what you have been given, you always paused for a moment to say thank you to your teachers before rushing off to your next class. You've showed your kindness to those in need through countless hours of volunteer work in your communities. I remind you that stars shine because of what burns inside. Your light, too, comes from within. When challenges test who you are, go to your own core. Listen to the whispers of your heart to find the answers that you seek. Remember that what is right may not be what is easy. Most often, that's exactly how it is. As children, you looked to the sky and you wondered. You held your breath waiting for a shooting star to disrupt the darkness. it is easy tonight to imagine you as you were then and the wishes that you might have made. Tonight, I offer these wishes for you. Remember that your choices matter. The small ones and the big ones, they all matter. So please make them carefully. Use your talents. Don't fear the judgment of critics who watch from the sidelines. Sing, dance, play. Never be embarrassed to be who you are. Forgive yourself and others because when all is said and done, we learn most from our mistakes. Find wonder in the beauty all around you. Observe your world and its miracles. Be grateful. Don't waste precious time worrying. Most things that set us back in life come from out of nowhere. When you fail, ask, what can this teach me? Find the lesson in all things. Make happiness your choice. Your thoughts belong to you alone, and they determine your outlook on the world. Work hard at something that you love. Rest your head at night knowing you have given of yourself. Act courageously. Never sacrifice your integrity because once lost, it's very hard to find. Don't hide your light. You have so much to give to the world. Give it freely and with humility. The stars we see as fixed and reliable in our sky are actually moving away from us. And it is much the same with you, our stars, tonight. This is not a sudden departure. You have been moving away imperceptibly over the last 4 years. You have changed, and you have changed us. You have been finding your voice and discovering your independence, and in the blink of an eye, you are ready to take the next step on your journey. Every time we glance at your stars, we will remember what you have meant to us. Echoing the words from your childhood, starlight, star bright, the first star I see tonight. I wish I may, I wish I might, have the wish I wish tonight. Seniors, now I must say congratulations and farewell. I hope the rest of your journey is a good one, and may God be with you every step of the way. As we close this evening ceremony, I leave you with my favorite Irish blessing. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold each and every one of you in the palm of his hands. God bless.